Human Rights Watch and Shakir have fought a lengthy legal battle against his deportation, arguing that he has not called for an outright boycott of Israel. The New York-based group says it does not support the Palestinian-led international boycott, divestment, and sanctions movement.
In fact, Omar's entire time with Human Rights Watch, he has held quite clearly to the organization's position, and we do not support BDS. So the Israeli government was never able to come up with a single case where Omar deviated from the Human Rights Watch position.
But the group's position is that Israel should withdraw from the occupied territories and give its Arab citizens the same rights it gives to Israelis. A 2017 Israeli law denies entry, visa, and residency permits to any foreigner who makes a public call for boycotting Israel or any area under its control, a reference to the Israeli settlements. The law was used earlier this year to ban the entry of U.S. lawmakers Rashida Tlaib and Ilhan Omar into Israel and the West Bank. Shakir says it is used to prevent rights activists from speaking out.
There is nothing special about what's happened in my case. The reality is it comes amid many other efforts taken by the Israeli government to assault human rights advocacy, beginning with laws that deny entry to people for their peaceful expression. Other activists have been denied entry, UN representatives. We know Israeli groups have been accused of defaming the state and maligned for those activities. And we know Palestinians have faced criminal charges and travel bans solely because of their human rights advocacy.
Jerusalem-based NGO Monitor, an organization that says it promotes accountability of human rights groups, has defended Israel's right to deport Shakir.
It's basically the same policies that every other democratic country has. There is no right for someone who demonizes you to come into your country and do that. If he wants to demonize, and he will, he'll have to do it outside of Israel.
The United Nations, European Union, and many rights groups consider Israeli settlements in the occupied territories illegal. But the Trump administration last week announced that it is reversing the long-standing U.S. policy, which says the settlements are inconsistent with international law. Zlatica Hoke, VOA News, Washington.